EA Sports. It's in the game.
This is the new wave, where things have evolved. The game ain't the same as it once was. This is NBA Live. Here, you can be the one and shine like the league's best. Anybody can get shook or dunked on or crossed up. And your newfound control over your strength, skills, and style is a beautiful thing. So do you want to be the one or the one who gets left behind? You have the ability to dominate on both ends of the court. It's all in your hands now. But remember this, the path to being the greatest, being the one, does not stop at the NBA. The game continues in the playgrounds, the schools, and the local gyms. This is where every real player developed their love for the game, where they paid their dues, earned their reps, and rode their own wave. From pickup games at the Rucker, to pro-am games at the Drew, to the bright lights of the NBA, the paths to greatness are limitless. And trust me, this game ain't the same. Are you ready to be the one?
It feels so good to be back. Let's get it. Team YNI, Team Young and Nail, I am King Shine, aka the Sauce God, and NBA Live is finally back. It's about time. Where you been, EA? Where you been? Face scan, pretty much clean. It's clean. It's just that forehead. God damn. That forehead, that eight head. Four head, five head, six head, hey. Big head, you head, we head, hey. That forehead biggest. Look at my forehead. Jesus. I could fit three fingers on my forehead in real life. That's about two hands. I need to fix that. But it's too late because I already completed and beat and recorded the entire demo. So we just gonna have to deal with this big ass head together, okay? We gonna have to deal with this big ass forehead together. And then the hairstyle I chose, this one right here, it don't make it any better. It makes it worse. I'm sleep. Anyway, I'm so happy that EA took the time out to put more hairstyles into the game. Customization is always a big thing for these type of games. That hairstyle right there is the DeJounte Murray hairstyle. I love it. I actually had that hairstyle a few times in my life. I just had braids, something kind of close to this. So I'm Jay Crowder hairstyle. They got so many hairstyles into the game. They added Lil Uzi hairstyle, which you see right now. They also got Lil Yachty hairstyle. They got a bunch of new dreads, and it's so many NBA players in the league today with unique and different hairstyles that it's so easy to just look in your league, the NBA, and just copy and paste the hairstyles into the game. Simple. So easy. Simple. But anyway, the creation. Now, I know it says like the centimeters and I know this was downloaded from a New Zealand account so I can get it a day early. And in New Zealand, they don't do the foot in inches. They do this. So anyway, I'm not going to show you the height and weight and stuff like that because I'm going to change that when the actual real game comes out. I believe on the same day as 2K9/15, September 15th, the retail version of NBA Live and 2K comes out. So, I can't wait for that. Khalil Rose, aka Lil Rose, is my player. Let's jump into the cutscenes.
Like millions of other kids, you dreamed of one day being in the NBA. You wanted to be a star, and someday to rise above and become the greatest to ever play. You dreamed of being the one. But the road to stardom is never easy. There are obstacles, injuries, and disappointments. Adversity is universal. It can happen to anyone at any time. And one day, it happened to you. You went from being a guaranteed lottery pick to a kid who may never even play college ball again.
Now look, it's always bad to hear about injuries, especially to college kids, of course.
Yeah.
But Stephen A. Smith, this one is particularly disheartening because we are 2 weeks into the season and one of the top NBA prospects in the country goes down potentially with a season-ending injury, a knee injury. That's a killer.
I couldn't agree more. When I heard he was carried off the floor today, all you can do is find yourself hoping that he'll make it back. That's the bottom line. But my heart goes out to him because I didn't expect this. This is a devastating injury. It's never good to have something like this happen to you.
The team doctor broke the news. Torn ACL, sprained MCL, and a torn meniscus. Surgery was scheduled, but your game will likely never be the same. At the 2016 NBA draft, your name is still mentioned. Not as a prospect, but as a cautionary tale.
Now, there's another huge story in this year's draft. A record number of underclassmen, 30 of them, undrafted. And I hope, anyway, that this is a lesson, this serves as an example to college players. I'm not talking about the ones who are genuinely one and dones, the guys you know are going to be lottery picks. I mean the rest of them. They're not sure shots. You're not sure they're going to be lottery picks. Don't just use the college system for a year thinking you're going to bounce. It doesn't work like
that.
If you don't have the talent, it doesn't work. You got to be cultivated in the system.
Please. There you go again with your blanket generalizations. You know how you are, oh, Max, the woe is me. Oh, my Lord, I can't take it. I just can't take it. It's a case-by-case basis. You can't just blanketly decide this should not be one and done or this should be one and done. You got to go on a case-by-case basis. Some dudes deserve to be one and done. Some people don't. It's on a case-by-case basis.
And that is my point. Thank you for making it for me. Every kid thinks they're the exception to the rule. And members of the media like, Stephen A. Smith, are encouraging these kids to come out early.
Look, Max, bottom line is this. You got to take this into consideration. You had two dudes. They were called the Height Brothers. Now, you had Nick Howard. This kid had a lot of promise. What does he do? He goes to college. Very uneventful first year, no doubt. The second year, he was pretty good. Here's the problem. The NBA, it's not about pretty good. You need to be great on the collegiate level, on the prep level, in summer leagues and what have you, in order for you to get the stature that you deserve. That's the bottom line. You're pretty good ain't good enough to be that stud NBA.
That's my point. That's exactly my point.
Let me finish. There's another example. I did say the Hype Brothers. I wasn't talking about one individual. I was talking about two. What happens? One and done in a different way. 1 year, one ACL injury later, and look where he's at now. His future is clearly uncertain. So you got to take advantage of that opportunity because you never know when an injury is going to cost you everything.
Stephen A., listen to yourself. Let's listen to yourself for a second. You give one argument for why a kid should come out early, a one-and-done situation. I can give you 30 arguments this morning alone why they should stay in school. And now you have to wonder what a kid like Nick Howard, who has given up his college eligibility, does next. What does he do next?
First of all, don't sweat the technique. The argument, or one argument, as long as it's strong enough, that's all that matters. That's number one. Number two, the Hype Brothers was something special. What they really, really need to do. I'm going to tell you what they need to do, Max. They need to get back to playing together. My sources are telling me the ACL injury has been completely healed. So go on a pro-am circuit. Go in summer leagues. Do what you got to do to get back on the court together to remind everybody of what you once were. Because once you pull that off, the sky's the limit. That's what they need to do. Get back to playing ball together, because when people see what you can do as one, the other arguments don't really matter. Like I said, don't sweat the technique.
So as you can see, they got First Take in the game. This is not me doing editing or anything like that. They actually got Stephen A. Smith and Max to talk about your player getting injured in college. And yeah, it's lit. I like it. The cutscenes is a little long, but it's cool. Now, the conversation thing, I like this as well. You can talk with your friend Nick Howard, I'm guessing your teammates, other players in the league once you get in the NBA, your agent, stuff like that. You also can be rewarded from different answers that you choose. You can rather get like a crate, which is kind of like a loot box where you can get accessories, the street clothing, or, you know, stuff like that, shoes, pants, sweater, stuff like that. Or you can just get some hype points and RP points. So I'm liking this type of stuff, man. They're definitely improving NBA Live. As the years go on, every single time they drop a new NBA Live, they improve. So I'm ready. I'm ready for the game to come out, like I said. And I can't wait. I like the game. You know, it's not perfect. No game is perfect. It got its flaws. It's got its ups and downs. But I'm liking the game. I'm enjoying it. And I can't wait, man. Lil Rose, Khalil Rose, is going to be a beast. This was just a creation In my next video, right after this, you will see Khalil Rose in action, chapter 1 at the Rucker. This is the court where you gotta bring your A game, and if not, you get booed and kicked off the court. Stay tuned.